This defense might be the new meta in Madden 23.
Got him!
It shuts down the run.
I shut him down.
Gets instant pressure against the pass. And gets so many turnovers. You will score more on defense than your opponent scores on offense. If you want to see what overpowered defense I'm using to get results like this, stick around after the intro. For the cheapest, fastest, most reliable mutt coins in the market, check out my coin sponsors at AOEAH.com and use discount code MONEY for 3% off. Link in the description below. In today's gameplay video, I'm once again using my Saints offense and multi-D defensive ebooks. If you guys want more from any of my ebooks, I'll have links in the description as well as the top pinned comment. All you have to do is click the link and the ebooks will download directly to the device you're watching this video on, or you can have it sent to the email of your choosing. In this gameplay, I start off on offense and I see that he is in a cover three, so I try to switch up to a one play touchdown from the PA seams, which I'm trying to do for a future video that I've planned.
Nope.
But he switched over to a cover one, which is why this doesn't work the same. So you can immediately see why this video is about defense, as my first offensive series doesn't go very well, and I decided to do the football thing, not the Madden thing, and punt the ball away. On defense, the formation I'll be using today has secretly been one of my favorite formations since I found it while labbing the multi-D defensive ebook, and that is the quarters normal. The play itself is called Under Smoke. This is one of the best and fastest man zero blitz defenses in the game for many reasons I'll go over in this video. I'm only going to make one personnel adjustment to start, and that is to put my fastest user middle linebacker at the middle linebacker spot, which I said in a previous video is usually N'Kobe Dean. That's mostly because I'm an Eagles fan. It really doesn't have anything to do with how this play works better that way. I just like to use him because I was super excited when they drafted him. If you want a better pass defense though, you can always put a safety here, but that will make your run defense less effective as you already have a lot of smaller defensive backs on the field, which can be something your opponent can exploit. It's also a good idea to have your best man coverage cornerbacks or safeties at the safety spots as they will be in coverage. Meanwhile, you can put your fastest players who are not good man coverage in the spots that are blitzing. On the first play, he comes out in a heavy single back look with two tight ends, which might look like a huge size disadvantage, but this defense surprisingly does very well and does not get weak box like you might expect. In fact, this is a very shutdown run defense. From this look, as you can see, we get a stop in the backfield for a huge loss on first down. The only way that I find you get weak box is if you guess pass, so make sure you only do that if you are sure your opponent has to pass. The only adjustment I make every play is pressing my secondary, which you can do by pressing the wire triangle box, whether on Xbox or PlayStation, and then down on the right stick. After that, the rest of my adjustments change based on my opponent's personnel and either the down and distance or the game situation itself, which I will go over as they come up throughout the video. The same routes that beat man will obviously work against this defense too, so make sure you are watching for crossing routes with your user as he gets the completion but just barely avoids getting his first pass intercepted. On the next play, he comes out in single back again. Anytime I see single back, I form strong, or any formation other than gun, I immediately expect to run, as most people run out of these formations the most since the cornerback is under center and much easier to sack when passing. The setup for run defense is simple, as all you have to do is pinch the defensive line to close up any inside run lanes. To do this, hit the D-pad to the left and then the D-pad down. This will stuff any inside run lanes while the blitzing DBs will stop outside run lanes and often get inside to stop inside run lanes as well, as we get another stop for a loss. On the next play, it comes down to gun formation, and since the first two run plays got shut down for losses, all signs are pointing for him trying to pass. I decide to make my run adjustment once again though, only this time I make one adjustment for the blitz by taking my user middle linebacker and hovering the guard pre-snap before dropping back into coverage. This will help the blitzing cornerbacks get in faster if I can temporarily occupy an interior blocker, which he does. As you can see, this is only meant to be a five-man blitz, and even though he has five blocking linemen, we end up with a free rusher and a guard blocking nobody. He gets the pass away though, thinking he can beat the press,
gotcha,
and we come up with our first interception of the game. So far, my opponent has run four plays with two runs for negative 5 yards in total and an interception to show for it, as we get more yards on the return than he got on his entire first offensive series. On offense, we are already in field goal range, so we decide to run the ball a little, despite this being one of the best run defenses in the game.
Woo!
With Vita Vea making the first two stops, we decide to switch it up and use my gun stack Y flex offense, which is an offense I've made several videos about already this year. If you want to see more about this offense, I will have those links in the description as well. We go for it on 4th and 1 and get the first because this wheel route is virtually unstoppable. Inside the 10, I made a video about red zone offense as well, where I said that this screenplay scores for me pretty much every single time I'm inside the 10, and that's exactly what happens. So if you want to see a link for that, I'll have a link in the description for that as well. Back on defense, the blitz is really heating up as on the next play, both cornerbacks get in.
Woo!
On the next play, he passes again for a second completion, but each time the cover is right there. One of the things I like about this defense is that you don't have any user responsibility on the running back, leaving you free to cover wherever you want. Most man blitz defenses, it's your job to cover the running back and your opponent can take advantage of that. But with this defense, you don't have to worry about it. On the next play, thinking like this gets me in trouble though, as he runs a screen play and the man defender gets cut blocked by the lineman. So I'll have to watch for the screenplay in the future, but otherwise the running back will get locked up on most regular routes. On the next play, he gets better protection though, as my cornerback completely misses the jam and he beats me with a deep crossing route for the touchdown. Back on offense, I go back to running the ball with the single back deuce close, which is really one of the best running formations in this playbook, if not the entire game, as I'm still hoping to make a video about this offense as well. Hit the like button, let me know in the comment section if you guys want to see that. I try to switch it up to a pass play to catch him off guard. My wide receiver gets wide open, I make a good throw, and I throw from a clean pocket, but Jalen Hurts is still so bad in this game, I get an inaccurate throw on the run pop-up as he sails the pass by a mile, resulting in an interception. When is EA going to give Hurts his flowers in the ratings? Dude is having an MVP caliber season right now. He's a mobile quarterback, and he can't make a simple throw like this.
What the hell is going on?
Back on defense, he has a new game plan, and that is to overpower this defense with a 3 tight end set, which is honestly one of the best ways to attack this. We already saw this can handle a 2 tight end set, as we knocked him back for a loss every time he ran, but from a 3 tight end set, it's a little bit much, as he starts gashing my much smaller defense. I try to switch over to the cover 4 drop, which is a slightly better run defense from this formation, but regardless, he gets into the end zone with another good run. Cover 4 is also a good pass defense, as he doesn't know where to go with the ball on the next play.
Get over here!
And we get a shed and a sack. On 3rd and long, we go back to the man blitz, as it's more obviously a passing situation now, and we hold him to a field goal as he barely makes another dangerous contested catch. He gets the ball to start the second half with a lead, and on 2nd and 5, he comes out in a shotgun look once again, so I'm going right back to that blitz. And I don't know if it was the pressure, the tight coverage, or user error, but something results in a drop. He called a good play with a very good man-beating route though to the running back, which typically gets opened very quickly against man coverage, and that's something you need to beat this blitz. So in the next play, I'm looking for it.
Psych! Gotcha, bitch!
As we get the lurk and take it the other way to score a touchdown with N'Kobe Dean, the scoring machine. This is my 3rd touchdown with this man in the last 2 gameplays that I've posted. Let me know in the comment section if you saw the last gameplay. On the next series, he comes back to that 3 tight end set once again, and I'm not going to play this game anymore. So if he's going to come out in this type of size, I'm going to match with my number 1 run defense, my 3-4 odd cover 4 quarters, which I also made a video about, link in the description. This run defense is absolutely shut down, so if I see a 3 tight end set, I'm going to go right back to this every single time.
No!
And we get another stop. On the next play, he goes to the complete opposite and goes with an empty backfield, which is never a good look unless you really are Tom Brady. The pressure forces an early throw to the corner route.
Gotcha, bitch.
And big play Slade jumps the route and is going the other way for another defensive touchdown as we take a 2-possession lead with very little from our offense so far. That corner route would have worked though if he had more time, so we switch it up to the cover 4 drop, and I think it confused him. I make a few adjustments, but instead I think he was expecting man coverage. He throws it up, and big play Slade goes full superhero mode, laying out for a 2nd interception on back-to-back plays. Now I'm thinking about just killing clock, and he knows it, as he is practically run committing with all the adjustments he's making.
Oh my god!
So we have to keep passing from time to time. In the end, I decide that I'm happy with the field goal instead of risking a sack pushing me out of range, so I just take the handoff up the middle and take the 2-touchdown lead. Now that my opponent is down big late in the game, I can go with my full pass defense setup every single play with no real concern of him running. To set up the best blitz and pass defense possible, I'll once again press my DBs, which I pretty much been doing all game. I will still stack the gap with my user middle linebacker before dropping back in the coverage, only now I can spread my defensive line instead of pinching them. So to spread my defensive line, all I have to do is hit D-pad to left and up. This will help the cornerbacks get around the tackles much easier. I can also guess pass, which is going to be the RB, R1 button and up on the right stick. This will make sure they go right after the quarterback, that they don't bite on any play actions or anything like that. On the next play, he tries to go back to the screenplay he used earlier, only this time I'm all over because I've been watching for it ever since, and he forces it up to his 2nd read.
Gotcha, bitch.
Floating the ball up for big play Slade, who gets his 3rd straight interception on the 3rd straight possession. I probably would have had another defensive touchdown too if it wasn't for the long broken tackle animation forcing me inside and losing all my acceleration, keeping me from getting outside where there was nothing but linemen. On defense, he's basically run committing with adjustments once again, as this safety is in the box way out of position, so we switch it up to catch him off guard, going right over the top.
Break yourself, fool!
As we get down to the 2-yard line. From here, we QB sneak a few times, just trying to kill clock. If we score, we score. If we don't, we don't. Then we go back to our red zone offense once again, despite my opponent being in a goal line defense. we walk it in as the inside zone parks like the Red Sea. Now up 31-10 late in the fourth quarter with the game essentially over and our defense scoring more than his offense has, we get a little lazy on the sticks, allowing some easy garbage time yards. We do add one more step to kick up the blitz into overdrive though by QB containing the ends by hitting the right bumper or the R1 button twice, and you can see the blitz is getting an extra fast with this extra setup. On the next play, Bradbury misses the jam again as this play looks like an instant replay from the first touchdown, which is probably why he's been using this against my man zero blitz in the first place. There's still a lot of time left, but since we've recovered the onside kick, we can go into our 4-minute offense, which is once again the gun stack Y flex, and put the game in Miles Sanders' hands with a combination of wheel routes and screen passes. Eventually, he adjusts to take away the wheel route, leaving the crossers wide open over the middle of the field, and we almost score as we get down to the one. The game is over, and I could take a knee or just let time run out, but if you're going to score garbage time points against me, I'm going to do the exact same thing. As my opponent rage quits with 1 second left,
see ya,
letting me know I have completely crushed his spirit.
With a bit of luck, his life was ruined forever.
So that's the vid. If you guys want to see more gameplay videos like this, be sure to be a subscriber, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section. Other than that, if you want to know more about the offense that I was using in this gameplay to put up 37 points, I will have that popping up on the screen right now. So just click the link on the screen to check that out. And that's it. Thanks for watching, man. My shit out.
Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my vids and more. Link in the description below.